We at NIMS have given our visitors a demonstration of this fiber fuse since 2009. More than 1,000 people have seen this spectacle. On seeing this fascinating phenomenon, everyone opens their eyes wide in astonishment as they watch the bright spot of light running along an optical fiber held in their palms. This man is a researcher in charge of this demonstration. However, he is not the man who discovered this phenomenon. It was already discovered in 1987 by researchers in the West. Then why is he performing this demo at NIMS? He started to make a study of this phenomenon in 2004 and found a useful method for investigating its mechanism veiled in its strong light emission. A review on his research has been published in this book. In this video, we will briefly show you an essence of his idea. When he started his research on fiber fuse, he could not find any previous experimental studies focusing the inner structure of the running spot of light. The spot was believed to be a small amount of plasma-like gas captured in an optical fiber. It absorbs an infrared laser beam coming from the other end of the fiber and dissipates the received energy in the form of visible light and heat. It is impossible to see the inside directly because it moves rapidly with a strong light emission. He noticed a series of voids left along the core of optical fibers after he turned off the laser beam. At the head of the void train, there is a long void in which the plasma-like gas was thought to be enclosed. Behind the head, there are bullet-like voids at equal spaces. These bullets were already known about on the discovery of this phenomenon. However, no persuasive explanation had been given on the reason why this unique shape is formed at regular intervals. One day he asked himself, is there a constant distance between the head of the first void and the rest of bullet-like voids? So he repeated the process of fiber fuse initiation, laser shutoff, and taking a photograph of the void train under constant conditions. Upon comparing a set of photographs from this experiment, he found the distance varies on each trial. Thus, he sorted them in increasing order of the distance between the head and the bullets. This approximates a series of snapshots sorted in chronological order. Then, he noticed an interesting motion appeared, just like a flipbook animation. That is, the long void sheds its tail, which shrinks to become the newest bullet-like void. We have to notice, however, that these photographs show the structure of cooled glass after the shutdown of laser beam. So it is not a direct observation of fiber fuse propagation at elevated temperature under high pressure. But it is reasonable to consider that this sequence retains a hint of the void formation cycle veiled in the strong light emission. He continued his research and succeeded to explain the void formation process. The key is to consider the molten glass around the enclosed gas, in which the front part is the hottest and the temperature decreases toward the rear. At the same time, the viscosity of the molten glass increases. This inhomogeneous viscosity of the melt serves as a driving force for the void formation with various strange shapes. Nowadays, many researchers in the world are working to utilize these voids as new optical sensors. As it happens, there is another motivation for him to continue the fiber fuse demonstration for more than 10 years. People get want to learn more about amazing phenomenon that they can see with their own eyes. He always catches the interest of his audience and promptly gives them some extra information about the history and future of optical fibers. That sparks a light of inspiration in adults and children alike. Although fiber fuse accidents are harmful for optical communication industries, he thinks that the most practical application of this phenomenon is education.